Hello, today we're going to take a look at PowerDirector 17. This is the new version of the software I've been using for many years, right back to PowerDirector 12, I think it was. So when CyberLink asked me to review this, I was more than happy to upgrade. So they've given me a copy of PowerDirector 17, which replaced my previous copy. So a lot of videos on YouTube start with a little introduction. You can do something very basic in PowerDirector, and that might be where you kick in the music. If you're like me and you've started out video editing and maybe you're using Windows Movie Maker, something free like that, something basic and simple, and you're now looking for the next level, that was exactly the journey I took when I selected PowerDirector many years ago, and I've never needed to move away. I found some of the other products that are available to be quite expensive. PowerDirector does everything I need. So if you want to do maybe a little thing across the bottom to ask a question or give out your Twitter handle, you can do that in PowerDirector. New in version 17 is the ability to not only have the text there, but to have a little background behind the text. That looks loads better now. It's something I've been waiting for them to do for a long time. I absolutely love the feature, and you may have seen it on some previous videos I've done. So as well as all the basic features such as editing, you've also got transitions, you've got particle effects, you can have little things popping up at the side of you, you can put text by the side of you, you can do all sorts with it. Now, the basic layout is very similar to most editing packages. I've tried a few, I've tried Magix, I've tried Vegas, I've tried Premiere, and they all operate in roughly the same way. So you have a little media tray. This is where you load in your videos, photos, music, or sound effects. You've got an editing timeline. This is where you'll place your clips and effects, and that's how you build up your video. And you have a little preview window. So I'm currently occupying the preview window. You can see a collection of media, and all you have to do is drag them down and you can very quickly start editing a video. There's extra functionality in terms of being able to speed things up, slow things down, reverse things, flip things over. You can change the colors, you can change the background if you want. So I'm stood in front of this white wall, known as green screening, chroma key. You pick the color and then you can take that out and boom, you can have a completely different background behind you while you're doing a video. For a lot of my videos, I tend to do a voiceover rather than standing and talking to a camera, and that's not a problem. Again, if you've got a decent mic, you can edit all your video together, hit the record button and do the voiceover to your video. I've also been playing with the collage creator in this version of PowerDirector. This is something that allows you to put in some really cool little transition effects while one video is playing. You can bring other videos on. I think the results look really great, but there's still work to do. For me, the editing within the collage creator can be a bit of a faff. You can't easily take a trimmed clip and put it straight in. You have to mess around trying to edit it, and that to me kind of puts me off a little bit. For those of you who saw my recent Vimble 2 review, you'll know that I used picture in picture. That's completely possible. Simply put a little video up and that can play alongside your main clip. PowerDirector has a lot of features that I don't use. So if you're into your action, you can import action camera footage 360 degree and edit that. You can move that around. And the only time I've used that was when I reviewed the Google Pixel and made use of its 360 degree recording function, and then I could edit it within PowerDirector, moving around that space to get the best shot. It's a really cool feature, and if I had more 360 degree camera footage, it's definitely one I would make use of. When it comes to exporting video, you've got a range of options. You can either select the exact variables you want yourself, whether it's an AVI, an MP4, etc. Or if you don't want to mess around with any of that, it does have a section allowing you to click and select what you're going to be using the footage for. So let's say you want to upload it to YouTube, you click YouTube, give it authorization, it will export the footage and upload it to your account. If you want to export it for mobile use, click mobile and it will set the correct settings for you to then load it onto your mobile phone. If you want to buy a one-off license, you can do so. Worth noting, however, that CyberLink are now copying the Adobe model, and they do have a subscription service available. So rather than paying a one-off fee, you can pay a subscription fee and gain access to their entire suite of editing tools. And that includes not only PowerDirector, but you've got various color grading software, audio editing. It's quite a nice little package. If you're getting started, you don't want to pay out a lot up front, maybe the subscription fee is going to be worth it for you. I still really like this product. As I say, I've tried quite a few different video editors and none of them have managed to take me away from PowerDirector. If you're new to my channel, you may not have seen my Eloquent Slider 1 Plus video. Definitely recommend going to click on that. That's a great bit of hardware if you want to get some really amazing footage. Just click the little box here and I'll see you over there.